The bath song is a fun song that focuses on parts of the body vocabulary, and it's an excellent tool for teaching the phrases can you and I can. It also explores bath time with a lot of actions, making it a great song for young learners. Stay tuned until after the song to learn some fun activities you can do with the bath song. Now let's get started. Your hair. I can wash my hair. Can you wash your feet? I can wash my feet. Can you wash your face? I can wash my face. Can you wash your knees? I can wash my knees. I can wash my hair. I can wash my feet. I can wash my face. I can wash my knees. This is the way we take a bath. Can you wash your shoulders? I can wash my shoulders. Wash your toes. I can wash my toes. Can you wash your hands? I can wash my hands. Can you wash your nose? I can wash my nose. I can wash my shoulders. I can wash my toes. I can wash my hands. I can wash my nose. This is the way we take a bath. That was the bath song. This is a great song for introducing or reviewing parts of the body vocabulary. To make sure your students understand the vocabulary, make sure to point to each part of the body as you sing. Or use flashcards, like these from Super Simple. This is also a great song for role-playing. Bring out some sponges and play soap and pretend to take a bath. Bath caps are also a lot of fun to wear as a prop during this activity. You can also have your students pretend to give baths to stuffed animals, making sure to wash all the different parts of the body. Little ones really enjoy this kind of role playing, and it helps reinforce the vocabulary. Try singing this song in a call and response format, where the teacher sings the first lines, "Can you wash your face?" And the children sing the lines that follow, "I can wash my face." You can mix things up and ask them if they can do other things too, once they understand the format and vocabulary. You can even reverse roles and have the students ask you if you can wash your face. Once your students are familiar with the song, pretend to wash the wrong part of the body and see if your students catch it. Like this. I can wash my shoulders. Oh, whoopsie. That's not my shoulders. What is this? Nose, right. Students love correcting you when you're wrong, and it opens up the opportunity to use even more language. At home, this song becomes a great bath time song. Not only does it teach parts of the body vocabulary, but it's also a fun way to encourage your children to start washing themselves. You can use this song as a lead-in to a discussion on things we do before bed or on health and responsibility. Try pairing it with the songs, "This is the Way" or "Brush Your Teeth." We hope you enjoyed the bath song. Keep on singing, learning, and having fun. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out supersimple.com for more songs and resources. If you have any ideas on how to use this song in the classroom or at home, let us know in the comments below. And be sure to subscribe for more teaching tips.
Woo!